Because defense deal running into tens of thousands of crops, the footwork is done by officials, experts, Air Force doctors. And he said that. And he said further, such deals are not struck at the summit level. Thirdly, he also said, I repeat for the sake of emphasis, the discussions were going on successfully between the HAL, Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, and the South Korea. Lo and behold, on 10th, a deal was struck. As part of the deal, we needed 126 aircraft. The number has been reduced to 36. According to the UPA contract details, 108 aircraft were to be assembled and manufactured in Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. But now there will be no manufacture, no assembly in India. Third, in every deal of major defense contract, we insist upon transfer of technology. Please remember, these are leading technological companies. We are not yet in a position to produce such a transfer technology to upgrade our defense capabilities. That age-old practice of transfer technology has been sacrificed.
How much? 41,205 crores.
205 crores. To this, what is their answer? They are saying we are purchasing some new accessories, some new equipment, some missile. It's not true. The statement of Mr. Modi on 10th April 2015, please note, I'm coming back again and again to 10th April 2015. The statement said the configuration would be the same as before. Configuration means, in defense language, the same aircraft, same accessories, same equipment. Now, where is the question of new accessories now? When the deal was struck on 10th April, you are talking the old accessories. Why are you inventing a new excuse, new argument? Now, I started today's interview with reference to Anil Ambani's genius. Nobody knew, Foreign Secretary did not know, that HAL would know. Foreign Secretary did not know the deal would be struck. The defense minister was not in the picture. The then defense minister, Mr. Manohar Parrikar, was not in the prime minister. He was not in the picture. But Mr. Anil Ambani knew just 12 days before the deal that this deal would be signed between Dassault Company and Government of India, and HAL would not be in the picture. There would be no transfer technology, nothing of this kind. He registered the company 12 days before the deal was struck. So if somebody had guessed the working of the Prime Minister's mind so correctly, so prophetically, he should be considered a genius to recognize everybody. The genius is simple. Mr. Modi, I level this responsible charge that the Prime Minister Modi and Mr. Anil Ambani were in collusion. I level this charge with all sense of responsibility. I have been a member of parliament and MLA for 45 years. I have worked on defense standing committees. I was part of the inquiries that looked into Jaguar deal, Mirage deal, so many other deals. As somebody who knows these procedures, that this deal would not have been possible if the Indian private company and the Prime Minister and the French private company were not to be in collusion. Please remember, Dassault in France is a private company. This aircraft production is so sophisticated. Only one third of the aircraft is produced by the Dassault Company. Two-thirds of the Dassault aircraft is produced by other European companies. Now, for such a product, Mr. Anil Ambani got offset opportunity. What is offset? If the contract is worth 61,000 crores, 50% of the export obligation is to be fulfilled by the Dassault company. For fulfillment of the Dassault company's obligations, the agency is Reliance led by Mr. Anil Ambani. Does he have experience in defense sector, more particularly in aircraft sector, the twin air fighter sector? Zero experience. Therefore, he is not a manufacturer. He is just a dealer. He is just a broker. I may also draw attention to another thing. Mr. Anil Ambani produced a brochure to make a presentation about the investment opportunity is a new Reliance company at Nagpur would present. Apart from 30,000 crores offset value, this company, according to his own presentation, would have an opportunity of 1 lakh crores of life cycle maintenance. What is this life cycle maintenance? These 36 aircraft had to be serviced. The spare parts have to be provided. The assembly systems supply in time. That will be costing, according to Mr. Anil Ambani, more than rupees 1 lakh crore. That opportunity also will be given to Mr. Anil Ambani's company. Now, what figures are we talking about? With my own experience, I am not able to understand these figures. Firstly, you have paid 41,000 crores more. Secondly, you are giving offset opportunity to a company in India without any previous experience in the field. Thirdly, you are asking that company to undertake the export obligations of the Dassault company in India. So 41,000 crores, 30,000 crores, 1 lakh crores. Mr. Arun Jaitley asks us, where did you get these figures from? We are not giving you figures. If you don't give figures, your friends are there to give figures to us. These figures have been given by Reliance Company. Your partners, sir, your brokers. These figures have also been given to a French private company, Dassault. They are not our imaginary figures. Now, you are all from Gujarat, and Gujarat is famous for its business experience, and we all admire Gujarat. The genius for that, you do wonderful business. Now Mr. Arun Jaitley does not say how much he pays. But Mr. Arun Jaitley says, our aircraft is cheaper than the one you wanted to purchase. You don't disclose the figures and we are the government. And you assert ridiculously that your aircraft is costing cheaper than ours. You know what Manohar Parrikar did? was done. He was not in Paris. Now the Prime Minister had done the deal. I beg it up. Did anyone of you ever hear of a Prime Minister's deal being backed up by a minister? If a minister does something, it is backed up by Chief Minister, Prime Minister, as the case may be. Here is a wonderful, unique case. A Prime Minister's deal being backed up by Defence Minister. During all these controversies, of course, Mr. Manohar Parrikar is not in the brink of help. I wish him good help. He has not said a thing about it. The silence of Mr. Narendra Modi is very significant. The whole country is shouting words about it. He chooses to keep silent. He is sadly mistaken if he thinks through his silence he can wish away the scandal. The scandal is too big. The scandal is too stinking for it to go away and so. What are we asking for? We are only asking for a JPC inquiry. And JPC is the same instrumentality for the government. Why? Majority of members of JPC would be from the ruling party. JPC can be formed, can produce a report in just 1 month. They say, we'll have to give government secrets. So the government is giving secrets to CAG. Right now, the CAG is looking into this scam. They have provided all the figures to CAG. Why should the government hesitate to give the figures to JPC? Remember one thing in politics. When you maintain secrecy, it's proof of your guilt. Silence is the clinching evidence of your guilt. Mr. Modi will have to pay for this deal. Such a huge deal couldn't have been a generous gesture to a friend called Mr. Anil Ambani. It can't be a one-sided affair. It has to be two-way traffic. Above all, I'm bothered about the country's defense. Our Air Force does not have adequate advanced aircraft. Our minimum requirement is 126. Why is Mr. Modi, who is a defense hawk, satisfied only with 36? What about the remaining? Will India not require? I was in Bangalore a couple of days ago. I met the HAL trade union. They were getting ready for producing, assembling this aircraft. Now that order has been denied to the public sector company.